Welcome back. Today we are making these delicious lemon raspberry cheesecake bars. We're going to start off by making the crust. I am placing 1 cup of graham cracker crumbs, 1/4 cup of salted butter, 1 tablespoon of fresh lemon zest, and 2 tablespoons of granulated sugar into a bowl. I'm going to mix this together until everything is really well incorporated and the graham crackers look kind of wet, and that's when you know your crust is ready. I'm pouring it into my prepared 8x8-inch square baking dish, which I've just lined with some parchment paper, and I'm going to press this down and around until I've created a flat, even crust. Using a metal measuring cup like this works great. I highly recommend it. Be sure to also get the edges. While that bakes in a preheated 325-degree oven for about 8 minutes, we're going to work on our cheesecake filling. I'm adding 2 blocks or about 16 ounces of room temperature cream cheese into a bowl. Beat it for about a minute until it's light and fluffy, and then I'm adding 2/3 of a cup of granulated sugar, 1 tablespoon of fresh lemon zest, 1/4 cup of fresh lemon juice, and we're going to mix that together quickly. If you want to, you can also add in a teaspoon of vanilla, but I found that it doesn't really make a difference, so I usually don't add it. Once those ingredients are incorporated, I'm going to add in 2 large eggs, 1 at a time. Adding them 1 at a time just makes it easier to mix the batter together. Once our lemon cheesecake filling is nice and smooth, just like this, it's time to pour onto our cooled graham cracker crust. So you can pour it directly into your pan, and then it's time to work on our raspberry filling. To make the filling, I've blended 3/4 of a cup of fresh raspberries, or you can also use frozen and thawed raspberries, and I'm pushing it through a metal strainer to help remove the seeds. I find that a lot of times the raspberry puree kind of gets stuck on the bottom of the strainer, so feel free to use a rubber spatula to kind of scrape it off. Next, I'm stirring in 2 tablespoons of granulated sugar, and the mixture should look pretty thin, just like this. We're gonna add spoonfuls of this on top of our cheesecake filling, and I like to kind of add them somewhat symmetrically on top of the cheesecake, just so that way when I swirl them together, it'll look really nice and pretty. To create the swirl, you can use a small offset spatula or a butter knife, and just create lines by dragging that vertically and horizontally through your batter. You want to make sure that you're pushing far enough into the cheesecake where you'll actually make a swirl into the cheesecake part of the bar, but not too hard that you're going to break your crust underneath. I ended up making 2 passes, both horizontally and vertically, on the bars, which created a really fun pattern that looked just like this. So once I was happy with my swirl, I popped these bars into a preheated 325-degree oven for about 37 minutes. I find 37 to 40 minutes is usually the sweet spot, and the best way to check if your cheesecake bars are done is to do a wiggle test. You can wiggle the pan while it's in the oven, and if there's just a small circle in the center that's still a little bit wiggly, that's totally fine and they're done, and it will set as they cool. Now it's time for the very challenging part, which is to let them cool. They need to cool to room temperature, and then they need to be chilled in the fridge for at least 2 hours before you cut into them. This part is challenging, but it's definitely worth the wait. They'll be so much easier to cut when they're fully chilled. I also suggest using a clean, warm knife to cut them and get clean slices just like this. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you want to recreate these bars at home, the recipe is up on chelsweets.com, and it's also linked in the video description below.